Alfonso, the first question asked is how much social media you have.
Really?
How many followers? Is it a kind of second job?
It's a complementary, it's not the main job. Of course, the main job is to win races, but to create content is part of the job because you need to get your audience back. So for sure, it's a very, very important part of the job.
You're becoming a publisher, you're right.
As a driver, you mentioned before, you go from that you see in cars that accelerate like virtually nothing else on the planet to a Formula E, totally different cars, on tight, bumpy, track in the city. And what is
the
transition for a driver?
It's so different that you can really split your brain and your driving technique into two different driving techniques, really. Although there are components, like I said, the efficiency that you can take one from another, the technique in the end is, which is, let's say, you can take on both, is how to drive quick with a limited amount of energy, and how to place your strategy with a limited amount of energy. And for a racing driver, it's very counterintuitive. You are following someone, and you know that if you spend energy, you can overtake them, but you know that if you use too much energy, you're gonna have consequences in the future. So you're all the time, I always say that Formula E, when you're fighting someone on track, it's like playing chess. You have to really make your move to make the other driver use more energy so you can attack at the right time.
That's really interesting. That's absolutely fascinating. You've won the account where you raced in Formula One, obviously you're a race winner in WEC and Formula E. But can I ask you the same question that we asked Alan Prost, Sebastian Vettel, and other drivers that have appeared, and everybody else pretty much has appeared this week? What was it that first sparked the passion? You mentioned that your dad wanted you to be an engineer, but what was it that first got you on motorsport?
We had this discussion, how old is the right age to start becoming a driver or not. And kids, at least on my age, I was just playing football, I was just driving go-karts when I was about the age of 7, 8. It was nothing, I didn't even realize what motorsport was about. But I think the first spark that made me realize how much motorsport was important was Senna in 94. I was 9 years old. I was playing with my controlled aeroplane on the garden. And then when I heard, I was not even following Formula One. I was too young to understand what was going on. But the impact of Senna in Brazil, how I saw everybody so sad, how I realized the importance of motorsport, made me think that it was more than just a sport. It was something that people translated their passion about. And this really hooked me into motorsport, into go-karts. Then I drove go-karts, went to Europe, Formula 3 and so on. Luckily I had a dream career so far, and I love being in motorsport. That's a very tricky question, and I have to be completely honest. I see the long term of motorsport, or at least the medium term, with a very difficult question. We are going through a very, very important phase. First, we are changing, for the first time in one century, the energy we use from fossil fuels. It was from steam engine to fossil. First transition. Now we're changing from fossil to electric. There won't be a third one, there'll be the last one. The electric, by the laws of physics, are the most efficient, so it will be electric. We'll start with small series and short races, we'll go up to Le Mans in the future. And the second problem we face in motorsport is autonomous vehicles, which is, there are two components, very important components, on the autonomous vehicles for the future. First, people will, in general, lack the experience of driving. I have younger cousins, they don't want to take their driving license anymore. So if you don't drive, you don't get the feeling and the passion for motorsport. Although motorsport will still exist, I think, in general, because less people will drive, it will become more of a niche sport than a mass sport, as it was, I think, reaches, especially F1, its peak on the 90s and 2000s. But autonomous driving can be very good for us in one sense. Nowadays, especially in Le Mans, you see technology being more important than the driver. No race driver wants this. Racing driving, motorsport, is about who is the best driver in the racetrack, not who has the best technology. Of course, it's also about the car manufacturers and the technology, but the technology on autonomous vehicles will be separated from a racing driver because you don't need a driver to operate these technologies and where the industry is going. So I think for the future, there will be a clear split between which technologies the manufacturers are putting into racetracks and how we can make motorsport more a driver-related sport, and the driver becomes more important than the machine, which is what we want to see.
That's it.